So God called Isaiah to be a prophet in a generation, and he warned Isaiah that no matter how you preach, anybody will listen? Yes or no? So pastor, don't dare to say preach this. Layman, we can. Okay? Again, you have to read the Bible. Then you understand. So God says, I send you, but it's useless. Nobody will listen. Would you want to take up this challenge?
Yes.
Then Isaiah says, till when?
How long?
And what did God say?
Until the city is wasted.
Until the city is wasted. Until Judah is destroyed. Israel is destroyed. We are living in that generation. We are living in that generation. We are breaking. No matter how you preach, very, very few will accept. And yet, why did God choose Isaiah to do it? It's because the message has to go out final time. We are the final generation. You are the final generation. That need to finish that work. 7 billion people needs to know. 7 billion people in the world needs to know Jesus. Need to know the 3 billion message. And it depends on dungeon. Is it an impossible mission? Jesus set an example. Let's read all this.
And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people.
So Jesus do 2 things basically. One is
preaching.
The other?
Heal.
Only 2 things he does. Everywhere he goes. Let's explore Jesus' 12 step-by-step instruction. Write that down if you are planning to be to do God's work. It's very important. Instruction number 1. It is about compassion. Just now I said love. Remember? The judgment is about love, which is compassion. Jesus in chapter 9, verse 36 says that when he saw the multitude, he was moved with compassion on them because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. So, first thing before you can succeed, do you have love for the sinners? Do you have the compassion to save souls into God's people? If you don't have that compassion, you will not last. When you face problems, you give up. When you do see men, you face some challenges or something that you don't like, you change. Sheep without shepherd. Today's world is stressed, full of problems, with family, with job, with just no time. Am I correct? Scared, worried, everything. They are lost. You or God. So, instruction number 1. Compassion for soul. Before anything. Instruction number 2. Then he said unto his disciples, the harvest is truly plenteous, but the laborers are healing. And what is the solution?
Pray.
Pray. Pray to who?
The Lord of the harvest.
That he will send forth labor into his harvest. That's what I ask you. Do you know your mission? Do you know your mission? Laborers are few. harvest is plenteous. It's an easy job. It's not a difficult job. But it takes a compassionate heart and it takes a commitment to know for sure the Lord has called you. Because when you face problems, you look back and say, ah, on such a day, God has called me to do this. Don't worry. So, before you ever go into a mission, you must pray. God, what is my mission? Show me very clear. Otherwise, Satan will come left and right, and you will doubt whether that is your mission. Pray. When you are short of workers, is it your job to go and hire? No? Whose job is it?
To hire
the manager. The manager or the boss, right? It's not your job to hire. So the manager will know who to send together to work with you. So, instruction number two, pray for workers. That means also, if you're not working, you don't need to pray this prayer. Am I correct?
No.
You cannot pray and say, God, Kavite needs this worker. Can you send somebody there? No, right? You must be there to work.
Amen.
So instruction number three. And when we have called and within his call, what does that mean? Call. That is your mission. What is your mission? What is your calling? If you really, just now, the first session I asked, I think only one or two of you know what is your calling. It's not you think I want to do this. That's not calling. Calling is God tell you I want you to do this. You know the sermon? What does God want you to do? That's important. Because ultimately you'll be in heaven to do what?
Managing.
Managing for who?
For Jesus,
for God. He says, do this, you do. Do you know what is God's mission impossible for you? It's impossible. 1 to 500,000. So number three, instruction three is called by Jesus. Okay. Number four, verse one, he gave them power against
unclean spirits.
Unclean spirit and
to
heal all manners of sickness. Before you move out, you pray, God, what is my calling? And God says, and you also pray, empower me with this too. Why only this too? Why not the ability to speak? You're supposed to open your mouth, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why didn't Jesus say, I give you also the ability to speak? Have you ever wondered? Huh? Strange, yeah? Why do you go to study theology to know how to preach? No need. God says, I don't need you to know how to preach. I will give you the power to cast out demons and also to heal all manners of sickness. Why preaching is not an important factor? Have you seen people who can share the gospel who doesn't know how to read the Bible? Yes? Have you seen anybody who can share the gospel who are deaf, dumb, and blind?
Yes.
Yes? And you? Yes? Yeah, indeed. So, number four, power to do two things. Cast out unclean spirit and to heal. Instruction number five. Says, and he started to name all the tribes. Can you see what is the key here? he named them? Pairs, pairs. You notice? It's always six pairs. Who is the first pair? What is the relationship? Your brothers. Second pair is also brothers. Third pair?
Publicans.
Fourth pair is publicans. Tax collector and doctor. Okay? They are good accountants. Okay. Alright, so the key is God knows who is your partner for the mission work. Is it beneficial to have someone partner you?
Yes.
Amen.
Our church only sign up one pastor. Correct? Why? But no salary. Why do the church go send out in pairs? They all have wives. Correct?
Yeah.
Most of them. Yeah, Jesus came. It's important because one is weak, the other can pray. One can do this, then can has strength in this area, another has strength in another area. But you can go into troubles, right? Am I correct? So it is good that God will pair you with someone He knows will work together, despite our differences. But if you go and find your own partners, most of the time you get into trouble. So Jesus named them. By then, Jesus knows them very well and know how to pair them. Relatives, brothers, and so on. Personality. So, two by two. Paired by Jesus, not by you. So we pray, God, who is my partner in the mission? Instruction 6. Can we all read this? Are you sure you have not seen heaven?
By faith.
Where can you find the Bible about heaven? Description of heaven.
Revelation.
Revelation is a book about what heaven is like. Am I correct?
Yes.
From the first chapter, where Jesus was walking among the candlestick, and then chapter 4 deals with the throne of God, worship. Turn to chapter 4. You can see who, what color is God. Chapter 4, Revelation. Tell me, what color is God? God's glory. Chapter 4. What color is God's glory? No, not before. Emerald. And? What color is emerald?
Green.
Green. And what other color?
Jasper.
Jasper. What color is jasper?
Yellow.
Red. So have you ever imagined God's color is red, green? And it didn't say white, it said rainbow surrounds it. See, you must read your Bible. Throne of God, God's presence, the light is green and red. How many of you knew that?
Jasper, of rainbow.
And the rainbow is around. And who else? 24 elders and 4 creatures. And what does the 4 creatures say?
Lord.
Holy,
holy, holy.
Sanctified, called to worship. When the 4 creatures say holy,
holy, holy, Lord Almighty,
that is called to worship. And the 24 elders fell on the top of the crown. That is the worship scene. So every Sabbath in heaven you will see. Most probably. So, can you picture heaven? The throne of God? If you read the whole Revelation, don't look at the prophecy, look at what heaven is like. You can see the full picture from the throne all the way to outside, to the garden, to the river, to the tree of life, to the wall. How thick the wall, how high the wall, it's all described. So, how many of you have seen heaven? Not yet, you could read.
Imagine.
Do you believe the Bible is true?
Yes.
So when you read, you must picture. Then you say, I know what heaven is like. If you don't know what heaven is like, how do you share? I'm from Singapore. I say, Singapore, very good. It has so this and this and this. You can share about Philippines, right? So if you have not been to Singapore and you say, oh, Singapore is very good, I think. So is that convincing enough?
Yes.
Then I ask you, have you been to Singapore? You say no. I only saw picture. So make sure, that's why Jesus says, as you go, preach saying the kingdom of heaven is at hand. If you don't know heaven, we are the ambassador of heaven. People don't see heaven, but you must see heaven because you believe the Bible is true. Then you can share with confidence, right? I'm going to heaven. Are you coming? It's different, right? If you don't know heaven, you say, maybe there's a heaven. Would you like to come? Would you like to have Bible study? It's very shallow. Answer, answer. We are ambassador of heaven. You know, ambassador represents the country. Who is the Seventh-day Adventist ambassador, Philippines?
Ihano.
Does he talk bad about Philippines when he is offered as representing Philippines?
Yes.
Oh, maybe in the country he talks bad. When he represents the country, he tells the people what is the Philippine Prime President thinking. What is the country like? He represents the country. So we are the ambassador of? That gives a different perspective to your mission. Am I correct?
Yes.
So you cannot say, oh heaven, I don't know. But you can go. I share with you Bible study. Go. I stay. You say, I go, you come with me. Correct? Then, people have confidence in you. Where is the text? That's the Ambassadors. 2 Corinthians 5:20. Write it down. Now then, we are ambassadors for who? Christ. And so God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead. Be reconciled to God. 7 billion people. It's a mission impossible, but we are ambassador. When we are ambassador of heaven, you know how much power there is to finish the work? How easy it is? If you are to finish by ourselves, our own strength, before you step out of this door, Satan will already kill you. Correct? Is Satan more powerful than you? 100 times more powerful. So, go preach the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And we are the ambassador of instruction number 8. 4 things. With the power that is given, power to heal and to cast out demons. With that, we can do 4 things. Heal the sick, cleanse the leper, raise the dead, cast out devils. How many of you have done at least one of them? Which one? Huh?
Heal.
Anybody? Cast out demons?
Heal the sick.
No? Raise the dead? Impossible. Cleanse the leper? 8. One day I was, I preached this and I asked, in Cambodia, I asked the pastor there, Tim Ngoc, I said, in Cambodia, any of these people is okay? Heal the sick, 19. Cleanse the leper? 8, yeah? Yes, you have no experience. Cast out devils, plenty of them. Raise the dead, anything. Say, yeah, once. One farmer, cow got killed. So they prayed, and the cow came out. So, not human being, cows. Raise the dead. So, we live in a world that's out of order, just like in Jesus' time. So much problem. So we are the ambassador with good news, with power to do all these things. But whether we have the faith to do it, whether the time is right. It says, freely you receive, freely give, as a condition of this power. Why freely you receive, freely give? It's because this is a miracle. This power doesn't come from you. It comes from God. So, God gives you this free power to do this. You have to give it free. Not to expect. Normally, when you heal someone, you pray and you heal someone, what is the likelihood of them rewarding you? Thanking you. Very high, right? They appreciate what you're doing. So if they reward you, what does it mean? You know, buy and sell, barter trade. You do something to me, I reward you, done deal. Deal is closed. But if you pray and the person gets healed and he wants to reward you, instead of rewarding you, he says, come. Let us thank, it's not me. Daniel, huh? It's not me who is powerful, it is God who heals you. So you pray with him a prayer of thanksgiving. Then, is it easier for It's easier, right? Instead of once you reward me and then you say, would you like to know my God? You say, no need, next time I have a problem I come to you. Am I correct? Next time I have a problem you pray for me again. Which is easier? Of course when you don't take credit, that makes the gospel easier to share. Agree? Understand the concept? Freely you receive, freely give. So heal the world, freely you receive, freely give. Number 9. Oh, this is tough. Provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purse. Don't bring any money. Can or not?
ATM.
No ATM card. No money. How many of you dare to do something like that? We live in a world that is so hard, so that we think no money, but no talk. No money, no
honey.
But did Jesus have to have any money to do all the work that he did? Yes or no?
No.
So provide neither gold nor silver. And why is that so? So we can trust God 100%. It doesn't mean that you don't. Subsequently, Jesus says that you do bring all these things. But at that particular time, he says don't bring to test your faith. Not only that, Jesus says don't even bring extra clothes. Extra shoes. Travel light, not like heavy, like that. So this time, I came to Philippines. Any luggage? This time I told, I said, I'm not bringing any clothes. First time in my life. No clothes was brought. Do I have change? Yes. I have clothes here. Kept in Philippines. Yeah. I'm leaving. I used to have to bring all the luggage with me wherever I travel. In big size also, no? So extra large size. So, but since budget airline comes along, Cebu, Pacific, Asia, it's good because we don't have to return trip. We can go on the circuit. So, go on those Air Asia, and we limit it to 50 kilos. No, that's not much to bring. So, yeah. So God is good.
Amen.
Now, he says, the condition is, for the workman is worthy of his meat. You don't have to have money to do gospel. You don't have to have extra things to do gospel. Because if you work, what I want you to do, I will provide your food. So most of us are worried about food.
Yes.
You enjoy the lunch.
One lunch.
Good. Yes, God is testing you. Workman is good because you didn't work, you didn't listen. Live in faith and live it simple. The more complicated we have in life, the harder it is for God to call us to do things. Correct?
Yes.
The less